You won't believe how bizarre Betelgeuse partly defies the laws of physics. At this point, it's a matter of fact that Betelgeuse, a red supergiant star, is on the verge of a cataclysmic event. This is evident from the recorded periodic fluctuations in the star's brightness, a typical behavior for a star of its nature. Though Betelgeuse, the 10th brightest star in the night sky, is destined to undergo a cataclysmic explosion visible from Earth, this is not its most intriguing feature. Recent findings have highlighted an even more astonishing fact. Betelgeuse is rotating at an incredible speed of 18,000 kilometers per hour, or about 5 kilometers per second. This is 10 times the speed at which we travel on Earth's surface, an extraordinary rate for such a massive supergiant star, seemingly defying the laws of physics. Yes, Betelgeuse will eventually explode, but it's worth finding out what is behind this baffling rotation rate. Today, we dive into the unusual surface of Betelgeuse and unravel the secrets behind its seemingly impossible rotational speed. Giant stars are the largest stars in the universe, with some reaching sizes of over 1,000 times that of our Sun. These massive stars are typically red in color due to their cooler surface temperatures, which range from 3,000 to 5,000 Kelvin, or 4,000 to 9,000 degrees Fahrenheit. Among the giant stars that light up the night sky, Betelgeuse, a majestic red giant in the Orion constellation, is one of the most fascinating. What makes Betelgeuse so remarkable is its extraordinary size. To put it in perspective, 1.3 million Earths could fit inside our Sun. Around 700 million suns could fit inside Betelgeuse. One of the most intriguing aspects of Betelgeuse is its incredibly rapid rotation. Scientists have proposed several theories to explain this phenomenon, including the possibility of a rapidly rotating core or the presence of a companion star. However, the true nature of Betelgeuse's rotational speed remains a mystery until now. As Betelgeuse approaches its end, astronomers are eagerly anticipating the opportunity to study the star's explosion up close. The impending supernova is expected to be a breathtaking spectacle, illuminating the night sky and providing scientists with invaluable insights into the final stages of the star's life cycle. Keep watching to explore the known unusual qualities of this red giant star. If there is a correlation between its impending explosion and the outrageous speed, and possible explanations for the seemingly impossible rotational speed. But before we explore the mystery behind its rotation, let's provide some important context. The star you're looking at is called Betelgeuse, and it's one of the most easily recognizable stars in the night sky. Situated roughly 640 light-years from our planet, Betelgeuse is a massive and radiant supergiant. Its sheer scale is truly astounding, overshadowing our own Sun by an astonishing factor of about 1,000. Betelgeuse holds a prominent place in the night sky, marking the upper left shoulder of Orion, the legendary hunter. The star's name traces back to the Arabic term Bat al-Jawza, translating to the giant shoulder. Its notable reddish tint stems from its relatively cooler surface temperature in comparison to other stars. Yet despite this cooler appearance, Betelgeuse's surface remains blisteringly hot by our standards, with temperatures reaching several thousand degrees Celsius. The story of Betelgeuse dates back to ancient times when early sky watchers first gazed upon the heavens. The exact moment of its discovery is lost to history, obscured by its long-standing visibility and prominence. Ancient cultures such as the Egyptians and Greeks likely observed Betelgeuse, weaving it into their myths and celestial charts. In the realm of formal scientific discovery, Betelgeuse was cataloged by the astronomer Johann Bayer in his 1603 star atlas Uranometria. Bayer designated it as Alpha Orionis, highlighting its significance with Orion's constellation. Over the centuries, Betelgeuse has been a focal point for astronomers, attracting extensive study and observation. Recent advancements in telescopes and instruments have enabled scientists to delve deeper into the star's characteristics, including its immense size, temperature, and variability. Betelgeuse's size is nothing short of extraordinary, exceeding the Sun by approximately 764 times. To illustrate this, if the Sun were a small marble, Betelgeuse would be a giant basketball, a striking comparison that underscores the vast difference in their sizes. However, pinpointing Betelgeuse's exact distance has proven challenging for astronomers. Current estimates place it somewhere between 500 and 640 light-years from the Sun. Hey guys, just a moment before we continue. Be sure to join the Insane Curiosity channel. Click on the bell, you'll help us to make products of even higher quality. So, what is it about Betelgeuse's rotational speed that scientists find strange? Let's begin with the basics. There are several methods to measure the rotation of celestial objects in the night sky. If the object is sufficiently large, such as the Sun, the Moon, or even a planet in our solar system, it's simple enough to aim a telescope at it and observe its features shifting in real time. For reference, the angular diameter of the Moon is roughly half a degree, and you can probably distinguish its features with your naked eye. Jupiter's angular diameter is about 1/10 of a degree, but its features remain clearly visible through a telescope. So what about Betelgeuse, the supergiant star just 650 light-years away? Despite its immense size, Betelgeuse is still distant enough from Earth that its angular diameter is 1,000 times smaller than Jupiter's, making it appear like a total blur even to our most powerful telescopes. Fortunately, there is an alternative way to determine whether a star like Betelgeuse is rotating. It's less straightforward than direct observation, but it's an ingenious method relying on a familiar effect, Doppler shift. This is the change in the observed frequency or wavelength of a wave due to the relative motion between the source and the observer. This phenomenon is named after the Austrian physicist Christian Doppler, who first described it in 1842. Here's a great illustration. It's the effect that causes the change in pitch of a siren as a fire truck passes by. When the fire truck approaches, the siren sounds higher pitch because the sound waves reach you at a higher frequency than if the fire truck were stationary. Conversely, as the fire truck moves away, the effect reverses. Sound waves hit you at a lower frequency, and the siren sounds lower pitched. What you might not realize is that the Doppler effect influences light waves bouncing off a fire engine, just as it affects the sound waves from its horn. As the fire truck approaches, the higher frequency light makes it seem a bit bluer. Conversely, as it moves away, the effect reverses, making it appear somewhat redder. This visual phenomenon isn't noticeable because the speed of light is vastly greater than the speed of sound. Therefore, it would take a much swifter fire truck for us to observe the optical Doppler shift. While we don't have fire trucks on Earth zooming by at 5 kilometers per second, such velocities are common in space, which brings us back to Betelgeuse. When a star is revolving, half of its surface will be advancing towards us, while the other half will be withdrawing from us. This generates a spectrum of colors emitted by the star that we can perceive with our telescopes, even if the star is too hazy to make out any distinct characteristics. By noticing which side is more cerulean and which side is more crimson, we can deduce the direction of rotation. Moreover, by gauging the disparity between the more cerulean and more crimson frequencies, we can compute the star's rotational velocity. This method was utilized by astronomers to examine the data collected by the ALMA radio telescope and conclude that the surface of Betelgeuse was spinning at 5 kilometers per second. However, the prevailing physics of spinning stars predicts that 5 kilometers per second is far too rapid a velocity for a red supergiant like Betelgeuse. Regarding our Sun as an example, its rotational speed is in the same realm, around 2 kilometers per second. But it's also 1,000 times smaller and about 10 times less substantial than Betelgeuse. If our Sun expanded to the size of Betelgeuse, which would envelop the entire inner solar system and nearly reach Jupiter's orbit, its velocity would decrease to just 2 meters per second in order to conserve angular momentum, similar to a spinning ice skater slowing down when she extends her arms. Moreover, if the Sun grew 10 times more massive to match the mass of Betelgeuse, its velocity would plummet to 0.2 meters per second. Therefore, the larger and more substantial a star is, the slower we expect it to spin. And yet, Betelgeuse appears to contravene these expectations. What are the notable theories and explanations for this? It's possible that Betelgeuse's rotation is the result of a process called stellar cannibalism. This happens when one star's gravity pulls away the gas from its companion star, which is usually in a binary orbit with it. The gas being pulled away carries most of the companion star's angular momentum. As a result, the first star grows not only in size but also in speed, spinning faster than it would naturally. But is this really the story of how Betelgeuse got its spin, or is there something even more mysterious happening beneath the surface? A group of researchers from Europe and China have recently proposed a fascinating alternative explanation for the seemingly impossible rotation speed of the star Betelgeuse. The team used the ALMA telescope array to observe Betelgeuse and found that one half of the star emits slightly redder frequencies of light, while the other half emits slightly bluer frequencies. This phenomenon was initially attributed to the star's rapid rotation, with one half moving towards Earth and the other moving away. However, the researchers suggest that this may not be the only explanation for the observed color gradient. Simulations of Betelgeuse's surface reveal a chaotic and turbulent environment, with bubbles of gas forming and propagating outwards at deadly velocities. These bubbles, which can be up to 100 million kilometers in diameter, cover a large fraction of the star's surface and move in different directions, leading to a Doppler shift in the light emitted from the star. The researchers propose that the range of light frequencies detected by ALMA may be due to this turbulence rather than Betelgeuse's rotation. If one of these bubbles were headed towards Earth, today's most powerful spacecraft would not be able to save us from its lightning-fast speed of up to 30 kilometers per second. Our only hope would be for the bubble to pop and crash violently back down onto the star's surface before it ever reaches us. As gas bubbles rise and fall on Betelgeuse's surface, they create a mosaic of regions that are moving towards or away from Earth. This motion causes the light emitted from these regions to be either blue-shifted or red-shifted. In a recent paper, an international team of researchers proposed that Betelgeuse might not be rotating as fast as previously thought. They suggest that the ALMA observations may be detecting a range of light frequencies coming from the star's surface due to the turbulence rather than the rotational effect. This means that astronomers may have been misinterpreting the observed shifts in frequency as a rotational effect. According to physics, there is an unresolved issue with this alternative explanation. A rotating star should emit a smooth gradient of light frequencies, ranging from blue-shifted light on one edge to red-shifted light on the other. On the other hand, a turbulent star should produce a random patchwork of colors, with blue-shifted patches where bubbles rise and red-shifted patches where bubbles sink. The question is, how could astronomers in ALMA confuse one for the other? If astronomers observed a smooth gradient of colors from Betelgeuse, shouldn't the patchwork explanation be ruled out? In an ideal world, that would be the case, but Betelgeuse is so far away that the image captured by ALMA is not sharp and resembles more of a blur than an HD photograph. When simulations of Betelgeuse's surface are made to account for the limited resolution of observations, they suggest that the bubbly patches of red-shifted and blue-shifted light will be easily mistaken for a rotational gradient approximately 90% of the time. This implies that even if the astronomers at ALMA made no errors in their analysis, they may have been misled by Betelgeuse's turbulent surface into believing that it's spinning much faster than it actually is. Therefore, astronomers are now focused on one primary objective: high-resolution studies of Betelgeuse that could distinguish between the two scenarios. The good news is that better images of Betelgeuse already exist, taken by the same telescope but with longer exposure times. On the other hand, it may take a few years for them to be thoroughly analyzed. Nevertheless, the answers are on their way. Now, over to you. Is it possible that Betelgeuse is currently rotating at 5 kilometers per second after eating its binary partner? Or do you believe that it's all an optical effect? If you like this video, then you should check out the one on your screen. This case will end in a supernova. Thanks for watching.